Good morning, everybody. Welcome to another episode of Sunday Back Mechanic, brought to you by Alex. In our previous episode, I have showed to you how to fix potentially a stripped thread on the master cylinder of my Formula RX brakes, which are 10 years old. This is the second part. So the glue should have cured by now, and it should have accumulated its target strength. What I will do today, I will tighten the master cylinder to its target strength, and I will take a bike for the ride to see how the repair actually handles on the trail. First thing first, safety first. What I'm showing to you is non-conventional bike repair technique. You should only use it if you really know what you're doing. If you don't know or if you're unsure, always try to use original equipment manufacturing parts, if they are available. If you're still not sure if your repair is going to be sound, you'll be better off replacing the whole component. If you're unsure that you can replace the entire component yourself, well, don't take any risks. Take the component to the professional bike shop. Need the shop to service the entire bike, then take the entire bike. Remember, never compromise on safety. Never, ever, ever. And remember, kids, whenever you do any work, wear gloves, even if they're just black neutral gloves, and always wear eye protection. This prevents 95% of all minor injuries and avoidable accidents. All right, folks. Now this is the moment of the final assembly. I'll take that the degreaser that I have put into this hole has evaporated, and it's right now safe for assembly. Right, so we put the master cylinder and the clamp. So it's, well, right now that we have this thread protruding out there, makes it can sit by itself. And then I need several things. First thing, I need to take a bolt, and I need to put a little bit of a Loctite on it. And that's how we do it. Just put a little bit on the threads. Make sure it collects. Yeah, what looked like it's so sort of a plastic. Yeah. Okay. Now wait. Make sure it will go all over here. Okay. Right. Now the next one is for our acorn nut. So we'll do exactly the same. So this is a nut. We have to get some Loctite on it. And this is how it now looks. You see there's the bluish thingy there. And we can try to first to screw on the nut by hand. Okay. Right, I have some Loctite spilling. Just okay, righty tighty. Now the question is, will I get at least 1 Newton meter out of it? Yeah, it looks like I do. And at least 1 Newton meter from the bottom. Okay, the problem is that this component doesn't sit, you know, 1 to 1, so torque wrench here is a bad idea. Yeah, because there is a miniature space between the master cylinder and a clamp, and because of that we don't have direct contact, so I'm just gonna go by feel. So, well, this should do it. So it's a tight, plus there is a Loctite in it. And actually you can see there is a bit of a Loctite spilling out, which is, can wipe it off with a napkin. All right, and I think this is it. Okay guys, so the master cylinder is right now firmly attached to the handlebar. There is a Loctite into the bolts and the nuts. And in principle, in this configuration, it can ride for any extended period of time. Now, the only question remaining is whether or not the echo or nut is convenient to reach from the handlebar onto the fork lockout. I'm going to talk about what fork lockout is a little bit later in this video. So, this is all for the repair and tighten it. Right now, it's time to get your mountain bike gear on and head into the woods. Guys, the ride test. I'm standing in the Elsenbury Boss in Rijswijk, and what I'm going to do, I'm going to ride a few kilometers here to get the feeling how this echo nut actually feels. It is a bit annoying that it actually sits on the ridge of the thumb to the lockout to the fork lockout. What is the fork lockout actually, and what exactly does it do? It controls the amount of travel that the fork will do. Here, as you see, the lockout is open. If I will lock it out, I wouldn't be able to depress it. The reason why this lockout is important is to optimize your climb. When you climb up the hill, you want to reach out and lock out the fork so that you get as much as possible momentum going forward. When you start going down, what you want to do, you want to reach out to a different lever and open the fork lockout so that the fork will get you more control. You're getting this in and out all the time, and unfortunately this echo nut has a little bump into it. It's not critical, a couple millimeters, but is it annoying? I don't know. Let's give it a go. So what I'm gonna do now, as a first test before I will hit the trails, I'll do a skid test. What a skid test is, I will accelerate and then I will make sure that I can actually lock the rear wheel till the point that it doesn't spin.
Nice.
Okay guys, so the skid test was a stunning success, as you have seen. Rear wheel locks very nicely. The master cylinder is firm, feels okay. An interesting takeout is that it's actually good that the upper shaft gets thread stripped. What I have realized is that actually riding like this, so for me personally, how I put my hands on the handlebars, this one should be slick and this one doesn't really matter. So with that in mind, the repair that I have done is still appears to be a success. I can take right now my bike for a spin on some more challenging single tracks that we can find around here.